So I'm Zoe Kernow, I'm the Executive Director at the Minack Theatre. We first worked with Woody and Luke on our band tent, actually, which is a tent that sits on the side of the stage to keep our musicians dry. From that, then we got involved because they brought a drone out here to site and did some scanning, and they showed us the scans and what they were able to achieve with those scans. And actually, at that point, we were like, oh, that's actually potentially really exciting. The Minack as a space was hand-built from the 1932 onwards, and it's not uniform and it was not built to plans. When we have companies who come to perform here, they have set designers who will actually design what set sits around the action to take us to the right location. Obviously, if you're that set has to come be carried down lots of steps at the Minack, and it has to actually fit the space. Having the potential to be able to send these designers really accurate plans of the stage area, in terms of literally, because the stage floor will slope in different ways in different places, it enables those designers to be really accurate in what they're creating and what's being built off-site. So when it comes to site, then it can actually be put in place much quicker and much more efficiently. Also, as we've started to produce more of our own work professionally, so we're working with professional designers, and actually, you know, obviously in this time of COVID now, we're all very used to working in ways where people don't have to travel so much. It was a real cost for us when we worked with a new designer to have to bring that designer down to Cornwall so they could come and be in the space.
So I'm Simon Hutchings, I'm technical manager. Andrew and I met a few years ago under a different project, and part of the technology that Andrew used to carry that out, I became very interested in as far as having information developed that we could send to companies, because our theatre companies are spread across the country, and if we get anybody that's new working, they cannot really comprehend what it's like to perform here, to carry sets and materials down to the stage. So the thought of being able to develop a piece of software to give them an idea of how this place seems when you're standing down on the stage was just, it really piqued my interest. So we started talking along the AutoCAD or CAD lines to develop a theatre walkthrough. And the more we looked into it, every time we thought we'd reached the end of the sort of the practical limits of what we could do, we sat in a meeting and somebody would say, "Oh, it'd be nice if it could do this." So we developed a walkthrough that could be loaded onto VIR goggles. And the first version that I tried, you actually walked through the theatre and made most people that wore it rather queasy. So we sat down and thought, well, how can we get over that? And then we started to look at fixed point 360 camera pictures. And so we built on that, and the new VIR system was fantastic. And we've sent it off to a few designers now, and it's just been invaluable to them.
Once we got that far, we suddenly realised actually this has got far wider uses than just to do with the performances that we put on the stage. And we started to evolve an experience which will help people who cannot manage steps. You have to be able to walk down 100 steps to get to the Minack stage from the top of the cliff. So the fact now that we're actually able to offer people, for whatever mobility issue it may be, the chance to experience what it feels like down on the Minack stage, exploring around the backstage areas, moving halfway down the Minack, turning around and looking back, it's been a really, really powerful experience. And having started that on the VR headsets, we struggled over many, many meetings with Woody and Luke talking about, well, how does the hygiene work with those headsets? And obviously now in the time of COVID, that's even more relevant. You can't wear a headset and then pass it to the next person to wear. You've got to sanitize it really well and make it really clean. So we started talking therefore about how else could we do it. and hence this 360 display, or sorry, 180 display that we've got here now, where you can actually almost feel like you're within that experience, but without having to have the headset on and have the sort of disorientated nature of that headset. And also operationally for us to be able to make the experience accessible to as many of our visitors as possible, if we were handing headsets out and about, that's got a huge staffing requirement for us, which actually is a big cost. So if we could find a way that visitors could just sort of sit within the experience, then that was going to be far more attractive to us going forwards.
I'm Alex, I'm the duty manager, so I'm responsible for the day-to-day running of the site and the sort of the experience the customers get when they come through. Once the installation was installed, it really opened up the cafe in that point, and it gave a visual representation of the theatre for people that weren't able to go all the way down, so they could see the theatre from all angles and enjoy it no matter what. The reaction we got from the customers was just amazing. They really enjoyed being able to see the bird's eye view of the theatre and it rotating, and then the wireframe structure that was on the projection. They enjoyed that fact of it as well, that they could see how it was built and how it came to its final creation on the wall. It resolved access issues, but it gave a wow factor to everybody else. Yeah. So no matter whether you could go down, you still got to see a view you wouldn't get to see because of the bird's eye drone footage. People were really reactive of it. They really enjoyed being able to come in and see this projection. Mm. And it was an eye catcher, because the minute you came through the door, it's the only thing you wanted to look at.
Thank you.